Now today we will discuss about the submandibular salivary gland, sublingual salivary gland and the submandibular ganglion. First of all, the submandibular salivary gland. It is the second largest salivary gland in the body after the parotid gland, and it is situated in the submandibular region. The submandibular gland, it is walnut shape, or it is J-shape. It is a pear salivary gland. The weight of each salivary gland is about 10 to 20 grams. This submandibular salivary gland is divided into the two parts, superficial part and the deep part, by the muscles, that is the myelohyoid muscles. We have discussed it in the myelohyoid muscles class. Both part, the superficial and the deep part, continuous with each other at the posterior border of the myelohyoid muscles. This submandibular salivary gland is situated into the submandibular triangle or digestive triangle. So this gland is divided into the superficial part and deep part. This is the superficial and this is the deep part. The superficial part, it is the large part, while the deep part, it is the small part, and the both part continuous at the posterior border of these myelohyoid muscles. Then now this superficial part is situated below the myelohyoid muscles in the digestive triangle, while the deep part is situated above the myelohyoid muscles, and it is sandwiched between the myelohyoid muscles and hyoglossus muscles. Now this salivary gland, it is a mixed salivary gland. Mixed salivary gland. Parotid is a purely serous gland. So it has a serous and mucus. Acini. The dominant, it is the serous acini dominates over the mucus acini. Now the capsule. Capsule of the submandibular gland, that is the false capsule of the submandibular gland. In this diagram, this is the hyoid border. Above the hyoid bone, the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia splits into the two lamina. It is the superficial lamina and the deep lamina. This superficial lamina covers the inferior surface of the gland and is attached to the base of the mandible, while the deep lamina covers the medial surface of the gland and is attached to the myelohyoid line. So the capsule of this submandibular salivary gland is derived from the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia, and this layer also forms the capsule of the parotid gland. So it is the superficial lamina and deep lamina. The superficial lamina covers the inferior surface of the gland, while the deep lamina covers the medial surface of the gland. This superficial lamina attached to the base of mandible, while this lamina is attached to the myelohyoid line, from which myelohyoid muscles takes origin. Now first, the superficial part. Superficial part of the submandibular gland. In this diagram, this is the superficial part. This superficial part is present in the digestive triangle and it partially losses in submandibular fossa. Submandibular fossa. The submandibular fossa situated above the posterior part of the myelohyoid line near the third molar and the premolar teeth. Now, this superficial part has external feature. It has two ends, anterior end and posterior end. The anterior end, this is the anterior end. This anterior end overlaps with the anterior belly of digestive. Anterior belly of the digestive. This anterior end overlaps, while the posterior end, this posterior end, it is related with the stylomandibular ligament. Stylomandibular ligament. This stylomandibular ligament that separates this gland from the parotid gland. So this posterior end is related with the angle of the mandible. And this posterior end in this diagram is grouped by or related with the facial artery. This is an important relation. The posterior end of the superficial part is grouped or related with the cervical branch of the facial artery. This is the facial artery. Now, so the superficial part has the two end, anterior end and the posterior end. Now, which are the three surfaces? Surfaces. That is the inferior surface. Medial surface and lateral surface. The superficial part, two ends and the three surfaces, inferior, medial and the lateral surface. First of all, the inferior surface. The inferior surface in this diagram, this is the inferior surface, the part that is related with the submandibular fossa. It is the lateral surface and this is the medial surface. Inferior, medial and the lateral. Inferior, medial and the lateral surface. Below it is the inferior, above it is the medial and it is the lateral surface. Now the inferior surface. If you see the relation of the inferior surface, it is directed downwards. There are five structures related with the inferior surface. The first, it is the skin. This is the skin. Then, it is the superficial fascia. Superficial fascia. And in the superficial fascia, there is a subcutaneous muscles, that is the platysma. That is the platysma. Number two, it is the platysma present in the superficial fascia. Then it is the common facial vein. Common facial vein. This blue structure, third, it is a common facial vein that is related with the inferior surface of the superficial part of the submandibular gland. Then it is a cutaneous nerve. Not cutaneous, it is a branch of the facial nerve, that is the cervical branch. Facial nerve, cervical branch of the facial nerve present deep to the platysma, and the cervical branch supply these muscles, platysma muscles. Then it is related with the deep fascia. Deep fascia, that is the structure 5. Deep fascia, it is the superficial lamina of the deep fascia. And the number 6, it is this surface is related with submandibular group of lymph node. This submandibular group of the lymph nodes, in this diagram there are 3 submandibular group of the lymph nodes, and they are embedded in the submandibular gland on its inferior surface deep to the platysma. So these are the 6 structures that are related with the inferior surface of the submandibular gland.